Hello and welcome to this video where we're going to take a look at the different CAD export options available in Kubla Cubed 2016. The first thing to say is that this is the Pro edition of Kubla Cubed. You can't export to CAD in the Lite edition, so this video is for Pro users only. And to start with this project that we've already defined the existing and proposed earthworks. We'll go into that in different videos. This one's just relates to CAD exports. So the first thing I'm going to say about the exports is you're only exporting the phase that you're on. So if you have different phases, you need to first select the phase that you want to export and then go into the file export DXF file. So in this project, we've got two phases. So if I want to export the second phase, I've got it selected and I'll go file export DXF export. Okay, the next thing I want to talk about is the shading. Quite often you'll want to export the colors that you've used to shade either the earthworks differences or earthworks levels. And to do that, they have to be set to discrete shading mode. That's because the CAD file doesn't support blending between two colors. So you'll notice this message here. It says the DXF format does not support blended shading. Please select discrete shading for both terrain and earthworks if you wish to export shaded DXF. So I'm going to go back into the project and change my shading schemes to discrete. So click on shading. It doesn't matter which one you click on, you'll get this menu and you can go through them all and make sure they're all on discrete. So that one, earthworks differences, I'll set that to discrete. And earthworks levels are set to discrete as well. So that gives us the option to export shaded surfaces, which is very useful. So we'll go back again, file export DXF file. And now I'm going to talk about some of the options that you get in this preview menu. So as you change the options on the left here, you'll see the export preview will update. And this gives you a good idea of what data you're going to get into your CAD file. So the first thing to look at is whether you want your CAD data to be two-dimensional or three-dimensional. Like sometimes you might choose to have all the elements flattened with an elevation of zero. However, that's not always the case. So I'm going to switch that to three-dimensional so that the, say, contour lines or platforms have an elevation in CAD, which can be useful. I'm going to select to shade surfaces, which should work now that we've set all our shading schemes to discrete. So there's some options here for side slopes. On the platforms, you can see might just be able to make out that there's side slope outlines and incline lines to help you visualize your building pads in your CAD data. The other thing that you can do is include contour lines for both the existing and proposed. These aren't necessarily the same ones that you've defined, although those ones will be exported as well. These are ones that are generated from the existing and proposed tin surfaces that the program uses to calculate volumes. So you have some options here to change the interval of the contour lines. You can also you can define those step by step, or you can select here and change. You know, I'm going to change this to have them every 1 meter, and you should see the preview update. There you go. So we've been through all the options there. So I'm going to click OK and save the CAD file. So this can take some time to export, but come with this progress window. So next we're going to go and open the CAD file and have a look at the data and how it correlates back to this project. So in this example, we're going to use a free tool that you can download, a draft site. So if you don't have a license to any other CAD software, we always recommend draft site's a good one to use just to have a look at the file. The Lite version is free. You can update to Pro, but you don't need to open DXF files. So we're just waiting for this to complete now. So this is a program by Dassault Systems, a draft site. You can download that, you can Google that and download it from the internet. Okay, so here's the CAD file that we've exported. You can see the project here, the platforms in blue for fill, and the existing ground levels shaded in grey. So all the data in the file is separated into different layers. So we'll have a look here. You can see it's sort of grouped into existing and proposed layers for the existing and proposed surfaces. We'll just go through what you can find here one by one. So first of all, the elements that you've used to define your existing and proposed terrain are all exported to CAD. So that could be contour lines and points you've exported from a CAD or text file to define your existing terrain, or elements that you've taken off from the site plan. So they will be in the existing definition elevation elements or proposed definition elevation elements. So this project has some contour lines that we use to define the existing terrain, so we'll find them in existing definition elevation elements. Just turn the other layers off so you can see that. Okay, next, for both the existing and proposed surfaces, you can generate contour lines. This can be really useful, say if you've defined your existing terrain with points, but you want to generate some contour lines to visualize it. You can do that with the options menu that we were looking at earlier. So I'll just look at the proposed surface generated contour lines. Okay, next we will find that in the proposed, for the proposed earthworks elements, you can export side slope outlines and side slope incline lines, and these can be really used for visualizing your side slope. So we're going to turn those on and we'll be able to see the two platforms that we defined in the project quite nicely indicated with these side slope lines and the incline lines to show the kind of direction of the slope. Finally, the two tins. These are really useful for validation and creating impressive images. Are in their own layers here, existing surface tin and proposed surface tin. So we'll have a look at the proposed surface tin. Initially, it will may display in a wireframe, so you can see the triangulation, but to get a better idea of the elevation, it's quite often good to put it into a shaded view and rotate it in 3D. So I'm going to do that in draft site here. Obviously, every CAD program has a different way of doing this. Okay, so here you can get a good idea of the elevation of the two surfaces that are used in Kubla Cubed to calculate the volumes. So that concludes this video into the CAD exports in Kubla Cubed. I hope it was useful. We've got more content coming out in relation to Kubla Cubed and estimating earthworks. So please subscribe and like this video if you want to see more of this. Thanks for watching.